the core.
Hello everybody. I hope you enjoy your FOSDEM 2020. Today we will discuss about the status of Node.js core. I hope everybody here knows Node.js. Please raise your hand if you know Node.js. Okay, perfect. Okay, first I will present me very quickly. I am an open source believer since a long time ago, and I am inside the FOSDEM DevRel management since a while, and now I'm working as open source architect at IBM with the help of Red Hat to help the client of IBM to migrate to open source and use open source every day. Okay. First, I want to say a big thanks to Beth, because in fact it was planned to be Beth Grings to be here. She is one of Node.js core developer from IBM, but she can't come for this Sunday. It's why I'm replacing her for this talk. But the main content of this talk comes from her. And by the way, about Node.js at IBM, we have 11 core developers inside IBM to contribute in Node.js. Other companies contribute also on Node.js. And we have four steer committees members in JavaScript. The steer committees is to define the future of JavaScript. And finally, maybe you might aware about OpenJS Foundation. It's a foundation under the umbrella of Linux Foundation, and the idea of OpenJS Foundation is to help the JavaScript ecosystem with Node.js, with the packaging. And IBM is also active in this way. Okay, now on about Node.js. First, the first information I want to give you, it's about you have several releases, and it's pretty important to understand what release you use for Node, especially on production, because it depends on the version you use of Node.js, you don't receive after a certain time the bug fixes and even more the security fix. It's why I recommend you to use LTS, long-term support, like you have for most Linux distribution, like Ubuntu or Red Hat. And for your information, for now, Node.js 8 is end of life. You won't receive any more security fix on it. Please to upgrade your Node.js version. And for now, the LTS version of Node.js is 12. You can use it until 2022 in safety way. And after that, well, you need to plan to upgrade to the next version of Node.js. Okay. We have a lot of new interesting features inside Node.js to be more enterprise ready. One of the features is around promises to help you to handle easier if you have several promises. We have now several methods, like all settled, to be able to wait when all promises are finished to retrieve all results, even if you have a problem on promises. Moreover, this is a very interesting feature for when you write async function or coroutines in Node.js. This feature, the async stack trace, enable you to see the path where the stack trace comes. It means for now, without this feature, you see only the last stack trace from this async function. And with this feature, you will see, okay, in fact, this function has been executed after this function. It's easier to you to find what async function has launched the stack trace. Okay, moreover, a feature from V8. V8 is a JavaScript engine used by Node.js, the same as Chrome. We have now private class fields where you, as you can see, you have a special syntax with a hash at the beginning of the name. And if you try to read this variable outside the object, but you have a syntax error because you don't have the right to read the content. We have also TLS 1.3. It's pretty important because TLS 1.2 has released 10 years ago. And since 10 years, we had several security issues with SSL, even with TLS 1.0, with Heartbleed. And several security actors has decided to improve TLS in terms of security and also in terms of efficiency, in terms of handshakes. And now it's natively supported with the latest LTS version of Node.js. Moreover, about the support of modules, for now, if you want to use modules, often you need to use libraries like Rocard.js. And with this feature, now it's native inside Node.js. We have also an article on Medium on the Node.js Foundation where you can have technical details about this feature, but it's mainly to have this the syntax import export to be used. We want to need to use something like Babel. Okay. And on Node.js 12, we have diagnostic reports natively inside Node.js. It means when you have an issue in production in terms of efficiency, or you need to know the internal state of the virtual machine of Node.js, you can now retrieve a JSON report with the internal state of your Node.js process. Moreover, finally, a long feature waited by the community is the worker threads. Is finally the API is finally stable. It means inside the Node.js for now you have one thread, the main thread, with an event loop. In case of you write a piece of code, use a lot the CPU, it could block your main threads. If you need to launch a computation, you in the past you need to start another Node.js process, and now it's possible to use directly threads, and it's easier to share memory between threads, and we have a presentation to explain in details what it means in terms of usage. In Node.js 12, we have also, in the past, when you start Node.js, you have some memory configurations in terms of garbage collector was static. And now, at the start of Node.js, it checks how many memory is available and define correctly the limits based on these values. We use also now LLHTTP to parse HTTP requests. and the NPM version has been upgraded. Moreover, Node.js 12 is not the latest version, it's the latest LTS version. And we have, you have also access to Node.js 13. It's not an LTS. It means at the June, it will be finished. You don't receive any more new versions. You need to upgrade to Node.js 14. And in this release, you have a better support of internalization. You don't need to use an external library, JavaScript library, to be able to translate, for example, the dates. Here it's an example to translate to a Spanish date. We have also some Node.js console improvements to be more fancy, more easier for developers to use with a completion preview. And this release of Node.js has initial support of WASI. Just before my talk, you add an explanation about WebAssembly. WebAssembly at the beginning was targeted for the web browser. WASI is a WebAssembly system interface. It's for the backend. And it enables you to execute WebAssembler inside the backend. And the interest of this, you generate one-time WASI binary file, and you don't need to take care about the architecture or even the operating system. Your piece of code will run. And to enable that, when you start Node.js, you need to add a CLI parameter to be able to execute this. This is a slide to give you an idea about the activity around Node.js core. As you can see, we have a lot of activities, especially in terms of pull requests. We have more than 2,000 contributors on Node.js core, and we have also more than 100 collaborators. It means they have enough rights in the source code to validate pull requests. But we don't have not only Node.js core, we have several working groups to do releases, to do security for Node.js, for benchmarking, to be sure we don't have any regressions in terms of efficiency between two releases. And one of the most important working group for you, it's the build. Because the Node.js build working group generates the binary you can download on the Node.js website. And here it's a photo of one of Raspberry Pi cluster we use to generate the ARM version of Node.js for the different Linux distribution. The build working group is maintaining the Jenkins CI as a build server, and we use a lot of Ansible playbooks to be able to create a machine from scratch and to build Node.js. And we have more than 200 machines and more than 50 operating systems, architecture combination. And thanks a lot about the donors for the build working group, because we need to host those machines from several clouds operators. And if you want to contribute inside Node.js, we have the website Node.js.todo, where you can see a small roadmap for you to be up and running to contribute inside Node.js. Voilà.
Voilà. Voilà. First question. Oh,
yeah, hi. Thank you for the presentation. The one thing you, I don't know, forget to mention that the spread operator is also became faster. It became faster 100 times as of Node.js 12.
Yeah.
Yeah, just finish.
Okay.
I have a question about V8 in Node.js. So when will you move to 8th version of V8? And yeah. Other question is, when will optional chaining will be available?
The question is when we will upgrade to V8
yes,
release. we have an issue on it. In
some blockers or so.
Yeah. Because as you can imagine, it's not possible to simply upgrade V8. You have a lot of links between Node.js runtime itself and V8, and it needs to adapt it for example, they change some APIs, they remove some APIs. At my level, I don't have an idea for the due date. But I know it's planned. Yeah.
Hi, I wish to know if something like async hooks that been a while in different versions of Node is and they still are experimental. If there is a plan to move it to a more stable stage.
For what API?
Async hooks, for example.
Here again, to my knowledge, we don't have a schedule for that, but I don't know.
Thanks for the presentation. So my question is that I can see that Node.js is still maintained, but actually the creator of Node.js, I saw once that he has a repo called Deno, which is in the description, saved Node.js version with TypeScript. So they are working together, or we will have a point where we need to switch to Deno or keep with Node.js?
To my knowledge, it depends on you can use all the extension of the file to define how you can the type of import. I think you have also an option you can pass via CLI for that.
Another question. yes, so I have a question about worker threads. So you have different threads.
Yeah.
And what about event loop? You have event loop per every thread,
yeah.
Or you have one thread on one event loop for all threads?
Yeah. The question is with the worker thread, if we have only one event loop or event loop by thread? The answer is we have an event loop by thread to be able to execute in parallel several event loops.
Sorry. They just understood everything.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
So, as you know, this is the exit. This door doesn't exist anymore. This is the exit. So, you'll have to come around. Blame me for security and everything, that's fine. If there is an empty seat after everybody has stood up, move to the left. Hello. Suggestion, critics, complaints, whining, ideas.
How are you?
All there.
Next to Beth. Yeah. In the office.
Yes. If you already have a talk for next year, also there.
Yeah.